Subepidermal blisters. Bullous pemphigoid.
Clinical.
Chronic vesicular or bullous dermatosis is seen mainly in elderly patients. Clinically, there are two types or stages of lesions, erythematous macules to urticarial. Plaques, which eventually evolve into blisters, and the well-established vesicular stage. With tense, often intact bulla that can measure several centimeters in diameter and contain a clear fluid and may be present on an erythematous or nonerythematous
base.
The bulla are typically located on the abdomen and the flexor surface of extremities, although they can be seen elsewhere. Mouth involvement is seen in a small number of patients. The disease runs a protracted course. Occasionally bullous pemphigoid has been associated with autoimmune diseases and with several medications, including sulfasalazine, ibuprofen, phenacetin, furosemide, penicillin, and others. The characteristic finding in bullous pemphigoid is the presence of a subepidermal blister which contains clear fluid as well as a number of inflammatory cells, including neutrophils, some lymphocytes and usually a conspicuous number of eosinophils. The separation between the epidermis and the dermis is generally
sharp.
The dermis underneath the bulla displays an inflammatory infiltrate similar to that described inside the blister. Occasionally in old lesions there is re-epitheliation of the base of the bulla, which starts in pre-existing hair follicles or from the adjacent normal epidermis, and the bulla appears intraepidermal. However, the roof in re-epithelialized bulla shows a complete epidermis with preservation of the reedy ridges. Secondary changes such as infection following rupture of the bulla can be seen and can distort the histologic appearance. Early erythematous lesions of bullous pemphigoid may not show a blister, and the histologic findings may be limited to eosinophilic spongiosis, which is manifested by the presence of eosinophils in the stratum malphyei, either individually or in groups. Bullous pemphigoid, pemphigus vulgaris, pemphigus vegetans, insect bites, contact dermatitis, erythema toxicum, neonatorum, incontinentia pigmenti, immunofluorescence. Direct immunofluorescence on paralesional skin of bullous pemphigoid shows linear deposition of Ig and C3 along the basal membrane, figure 5.3. IM and IgA sometimes are also positive. On salt-split skin, the immunoreactants appear on the roof of the bulla. The bullous pemphigoid antigen appears to be associated with the lamina lucida and the hemidesmosomes of the basal keratinocytes. Electron microscopy: the split takes place along the lamina lucida with destruction of the hemidesmosomes. Differential diagnosis: the bulla in dermatitis herpetiformis show abundant neutrophils but few, if any, eosinophils. There are also microabscesses in the dermal papillae.
Epidermolysis.
Dermatitis herpetiformis, cicatricial pemphigoid, bullous lupus, erythematosus, linear IgA, bullous dermatosis, pemphigoid gestationes, with eosinophils, bullosa acquisita, EBA, is usually less cellular, but often the differential diagnosis rests on immunofluorescence. In salt split preparations, the immunoreactants are in the dermal side in EVA, or electron microscopy, decrease or absence of anchoring fibrils.